The smoke is on, and let's start the music for Mr. John Collver in the SNJ5. John dedicates his performance to veterans young and old, 1941 to present, and to the families that they leave behind. John began flying at the age of 13. He had to ride a bike out to the airport to take his lessons. At the age of 16, and before he even had a driver's license, John soloed 5 different types of airplanes. At this time, John's flying career spans 40 years. He's logged more than 14,500 hours and has flown over 50 different types of airplanes, including the Goodyear Blimp, Columbia, and Television's Airwolf helicopter. John has flown numerous airplanes from turboprops to jets, Northrop Grumman, an aerospace company. As a corporate pilot there, he flew such notable figures as Vice President Dick Cheney, California Senators Barbara Boxer, Dianne Feinstein, and former Defense Secretary Caspar Weinberger. Here he is from the left in the SNJ-5. For San Francisco's 50th anniversary of the Golden Gate Bridge. He's also organized and flown such events as San Diego's commemoration of Pearl Harbor and the Little Raiders operation of World War II. John is an experienced aerobatic instructor with high rankings in the International Aerobatic Gold Cup Championship. He is currently an air show safety evaluator. John and War Dog have been featured in numerous national and international publications, television programs, and feature films, including Gypsy Angels, an advanced action picture, 1989, which starred Vanna White. The North American T-6 SNJ was designed in the 30s as an advanced fighter trainer. It served as a stepping stone to fighters, like I said, the Mustang, the F-86 Sabre jet, flown through World War II. Constantly underwent modifications. The latest model was produced in the 1950s. During the Korean War, the U.S. Air Force and Marine Corps used the plane as forward air controllers, and the T-6 claimed 1 kill a MiG. No other trainer in history has been used by so many countries, spanning the period from 1930 until present. Turkey continues to fly these today. Let's watch and listen now. Valley in the sky with the SNJ-5 and John Cope.
Yeah.
retired from the U.S. Armed Forces back in the 50s. Then she served as part of the Japanese Self-Defense Force back up until 1964, if you believe that. Then to be scrapped in 1977. By Warbirds of Compton, California, John helped with the plane's restoration and became its new owner. Incidentally, that loud noise that you hear is not the engine making that noise. It's the tip of the propeller. It's going almost supersonic up there, and that's what makes that very, very loud noise. 600 horsepower Pratt & Whitney engine. Air-breathing engine, not like the jets out here, and suffers a little bit of performance at this altitude of 3,000 feet above sea level, and it's made even higher by what we call density altitude. When the temperature gets higher, the density altitude, John. It's like, as I said, a ballet in the sky with the SNG 5. He's experienced temperatures inside that cockpit up to 127 degrees and 4 to 6 Gs as he flies the SNG 5. John loves flying and hates flying straight and level. You can see that by his performance. Always got the airplane moving one way or the other. Most aerobatic pilots are like that. Don't like straight and level. Landing gear down is John Collver. illustrates the SMJ5. Little wave to you there. Wave back to John. He can see you there. And he's looking for a wave to make sure you enjoy it. John Collver on downwind for landing.